To wrap up today's lecture, the declaration of an identifier tells the compiler the type. Then we had the definition, which reserves actually space for an object in memory. Now, both of these informations are stored in something called the symbol table inside the compiler. This symbol table is slightly different from the symbol table that the compiler keeps and stores in an object file, and where it is needed for the linker to combine symbols across compilation units. So any identifier that you have in this symbol table can be used in the different compilation units, and when we have external linkage, but when we have internal linkage, you can only link it within the same compilation unit. That means you have to use static, for example, as a keyword, as a modifier to a variable or a function. By default, functions are externally linkable and global variables as well. So these compilation units, they help us to structure the code development, and a compilation unit typically results in an object file. We had the storage class that defines the lifetime of an object. Auto was used on block level, which means the data is kept inside our stack. We had static variables, that means it's stored on basically the stack as long as the program runs, but it's internally linked. And we had the global variables, that means the variable is stored on the stack during the whole runtime and it's externally linked. So again, if you find this today a little bit confusing, I understand. There's a lot of terminology. Sometimes, and not sometimes, quite frequently, it's difficult for me to distinguish all these different notions. But like I said, basically we will practice the symbol table and in the linker in one of our tutorials, such that you can understand the difference between internal, external linkage and no linkage. And lastly, you know, you will encounter in the programs that you study those keywords. That's where you go back to this lecture and have a look. Nevertheless, try to understand them and try to understand the differences of the different modifiers for a variable, to understand the scope and the storage class. Hope you have a nice week.